In this video, I will explain working with authentication and authorization. So authentication is about where Kubernetes users come from. The kubectl config specifies to which cluster to authenticate. We have seen how kubectl config view can be used to see the current settings, which is basically a couple of certificates that allow the current computer to connect to the API in the Kubernetes cluster. Then authorization is what these specific users can do. Behind authorization, there's RBAC, which takes care of the different options. And if you want to know what you can do, you can use kubectl auth, can I, followed by something. That's a convenient command. For example, you can use kubectl, can I get pods, to find out if you can create pods. Let's do a few quick examples with this kubectl auth, can I. All right, let's do kubectl, can I. So kubectl auth. There's help. You see there's not much that can be done. But what there is interesting. For CKAD, can I is good enough. Can I get pods, for example, is telling me yes. And can I get pods --s Lisa at example.com doesn't know any Lisa. So the answer is no. So if at any time you are unsuccessful in doing something, it can be because some advanced RBAC configuration is in place. If you want to test if you should be able to do what you want to do, kubectl auth can I is going to give you that information.